Welcome to In Dark Places, because you're worth it. This is episode 36. We're glad you can make it. We've been going over so many fun stories here lately, we've kind of missed over some interesting news articles. So this week we're going to devote the whole episode to some items that you may not have heard about in the news. Kicking things off this week, here's my friend Mr. Haunted. Take it away, Jimmy.
This story comes out of Wichita, Kansas. A Home Depot's customer's polite warning that the end of days was imminent, announcing to others that he was going to use the restroom, was mistaken for a bomb threat in Wichita. Wichita Police Department was called to a Home Depot on Monday afternoon for a reported bomb threat. "We just had a customer here make what may have been a bomb threat," a man told the 911 dispatcher in released audio of the call. "He said, somebody told me there's a bomb in here and you need to leave the building. He said it three times." Well, police responded to the home renovation store and learned the threat came from someone in the store's restroom. An employee told the responding officers he was standing at the urinal when another gentleman came out of a stall and said, "Somebody told me there's a bomb in the building. You need to leave the building." Well, according to the newspaper, a store clerk recognized the man because he's a regular customer and gave the man's name to police. Officers contacted the man and he explained to the cops that he had no intention of causing such alarm and that the comment he said was meant to be funny. Turns out, the man was also in the washroom when at some point, another gentleman gave the warning, "Y'all need to get out of here because I'm fixing to blow it up." A comment he got the gist of, understanding the man was in a serious need to relieve himself and that he was attempting to provide a polite warning to the other patrons of the bathroom. The regular customer told police he gave the warning to the employee in the washroom, meaning it to be a joke. I guess he didn't know the man's bathroom humor was taken so seriously. No charges were filed. Perhaps next time a courtesy flush will suffice. There's the Home Depot bomb threat news for you.
Boy, that's a pretty crappy story. You know what? I've got a topic that's kind of similar. Woman mistook earbud for pill, pooped it out. By Asia Grace. Thanks, Asia. After broadcasting her shame to the world, a woman named Carly Belmer is going viral for a series of TikTok posts in which she claimed she accidentally mistook her Apple AirPod for ibuprofen, swallowed it whole, and ultimately pooped it out. But not before the device blasted a voice memo from inside her stomach. "So like, I ate my AirPod," a blubbering Belmer, 27, better known to her 3,200 followers as "I am Carly Lee," explained in a video that's garnered over 2.4 million views. "I was crawling into my bed and I had an ibuprofen 800 in one hand and my AirPod in the other," she continued. Belmer said she then mindlessly popped what she thought was the anti-inflammatory pill in her mouth and quickly flushed it down with a swig of water. "I then realized that it wasn't the ibuprofen," she sobbed. "I tried puking it and it won't come out." and I'm losing my mind," Belmer proclaimed in her weepy video. The video cuts to a less weepy explanation of why she wanted to share the mind-boggling mishap online. "I'm not the first one to do this, and definitely won't be the last," Belmer insisted. "So for educational purposes, I wanted to share my journey of how this is all going," she said. In a follow-up post, Belmer assured inquiring minds that an x-ray examination confirmed that the AirPod had exited her stomach by way of defecation.
This next story comes out of Massachusetts, where a Massachusetts family is suing after man's casket opens and body falls out. A Massachusetts family whose loved one's corpse fell out of the casket as it was being lowered into the grave has sued the funeral home and the cemetery. During Andrew Serrano's funeral, April 5th, 2019, at city-owned Bellevue Cemetery in Lawrence, one of the side straps on the casket-lowering device snapped. When the casket broke apart, Mr. Serrano's corpse fell out of the casket into the grave and began oozing fluid in full view of the horrified family members, who became visibly distraught and hysterical. According to the lawsuit filed last Wednesday in Essex Superior Court, several distraught family members leaped into the grave to retrieve Serrano's body, the local paper reported. Serrano's family alleges negligence and reckless infliction of emotional distress and names the City of Lawrence, E&J Memorial Services, and the Bellevue Cemetery Board of Trustees. The family is seeking more than $50,000 in damages. Wow.
That would not be good.
Earth has a second moon, for another 300 years at least, by Jeffrey Kluger. Thanks, Jeffrey. It's easy to be brand loyal to the moon. We've only got one, after all, unlike Jupiter and Saturn, where you'd have dozens to choose from. Here, it's Luna, or nada, or not. The fact is, there's another sorta, kinda, moon in a sorta, kinda, orbit around Earth that was discovered only in 2016. And according to a new study in Nature, we may at last know how it was formed. The quasi-moon named Komoiakulakua, after a Hawaiian word that refers to a moving celestial object, is not much to speak of, measuring less than 50 meters, 140 feet across. It circles the Earth in a repeating corkscrew-like trajectory that brings it no closer than 40 to 100 times the distance of our more familiar moon. Its odd flat path is caused by the competing gravitational pulls of the Earth and the Sun, which continually bend and torque the moonlet's motions, preventing it from achieving a more conventional orbit.
It's primarily influenced just by the Sun's gravity, but this pattern shows up because it's also, but not quite, on an Earth-like orbit. So, it's this sort of odd dance, says graduate student Ben Sharkey of the Lunar and Planetary Laboratory at the University of Arizona, the lead author of the paper. None of this means that Komoiakulakua has to have especially exotic origins. The solar system is littered with asteroids, some of which are captured by the gravity of other planets and become more conventional, if fragmentary, moons. Others don't orbit other planets in the common way, but do fall into line in front of them or behind them and pace them in their orbits around the Sun, like the flocks of so-called Trojan asteroids that precede and trail Jupiter. Either way, Komoiakulakua was bound to get attention because its composition posed a stubborn mystery. Asteroids tend to reflect brightly in certain infrared frequencies, but Kamakura just doesn't. It's dimmer somehow, clearly made of different stuff. The rock was made of common silicates, like other asteroids, but they were common only in their general composition, not in their infrared signature, which remained stubbornly off. At last, the answer suggested itself. If Kamakura was behaving like a sort of quasi-moon, perhaps it was an artifact of the actual moon. Earlier in Sharkey's PhD program, one of his advisors published a paper on lunar samples brought back by the Apollo 14 mission in 1971. When Sharkey compared the data he was getting in his telescope with what the earlier geologists came up with in the rock lab, the results matched perfectly. The kind of space weathering lunar silicates undergo when they're still on the surface of the moon precisely accounted for the differences in the infrared reflectivity between common asteroids and Kamakura. According to estimates from Sharkey and others, the object will remain an earthly companion for only about 300 more years.
This story is called Young Girl Mistakes Mom for Alien. Mom, Shakira Brandon, had to console her daughter, Noli Joy, after the young girl mistook her mom for an alien after seeing a photo of space in the mom's passport. The mom posted the video to Twitter, where it's received 2 million views. My daughter found my passport today, and she thought it was paperwork to show him an alien. The mother wrote, should have never let her watch Men in Black. And here's the audio.
And what do you think that means, mommy? I'm an alien. You think that means I'm an alien? Mommy, look. It's not meaning I'm an alien. These are the places that mommy has traveled to, and this is just a picture of the earth as I travel. You scared of mommy now? Come here. Why are you crying? And what do you think that means, mommy?
I'm an alien.
You think that means I'm an alien? Mommy, look. It's not meaning I'm an alien. These are the places that mommy has traveled to, and this is just a picture of the earth as I travel.
Anyway, I always like to read the comments underneath these videos. The Pickerel wrote, she's going to be crushed when she learns it's the humans you have to watch out for. Land of the Living Skies says, my son at 8 years old made sure his cat slept with him every night because, you know, in case the aliens abducted him, at least he wouldn't be alone. We laugh now, but he was truly afraid of aliens as a kid. To the mom, enjoy being called an alien now. It will only get worse as you get older. And then what else do we have here? Oh, poor baby, she needs a hug. And Almasi Brown writes, little girl has been low-key watching Alex Jones. And there's your young girl mistakes mom for an alien news story.
Smart kid. There you go, question everything. Strange droning noise that makes locals' bodies vibrate. Spreads to village nearby. By Nick Dawson Chiara Fiorio. Thanks, Nick. A strange noise that has been bothering villagers for a year now can be heard
from people living miles away, too. Residents in Earl Shilton, Leicestershire, said the low-frequency droning sound has become louder in recent weeks. Now, Brian Heath, who lives in nearby Stapleton, said the sound can be heard from there, too. He told Leicestershire Live, "It's quite a heavy noise. It makes your body vibrate. The air is moving so much. It's very low level, but you can feel the pressure on your body. It's a weird noise. It could be drilling, driving through rock. I used to work for British Gas. We used to get a lot of tunnel boring. It's a very deep sound. It's there all the time." People in Barwell can hear the strange sound too. Brian said the noise does not bother him much, but he can hear it while he's watching TV. Angie Ridshaw, who lives in nearby Barwell, said the strange sound can be heard 24 hours a day, even over traffic noise. And at night, a vibration can be felt while lying on the pillow. Local resident Robert Elsley, director of PES UK Limited, an engineering firm based in Burbage, suggested the source of the peculiar noise may be a noisy transformer. He explained, "My company installs acoustic enclosures and walls around and in front of transformers to reduce noise affecting local neighborhoods. We worked on a similar project about 3 years ago. Noise from a large transformer made items inside a house vibrate." Another person suggested the sound may be related to an electrical issue, as they said, "With the description of the noise being constant, pulsating, and humming, this most likely points to being an EMI, electric magnetic interference, issue, as it matches the characteristics of electricity, similar to a dodgy light, dimmer switch, etc., if you have ever heard one." Severn Trent Water and Western Power Distribution told Leicestershire Live they were not aware of any issues in the area, and they had not received any reports about the noise.
Three dead, hundreds injured after storms roused scorpions in Egypt. Three people are dead and hundreds are injured after inclement weather roused hordes of venomous scorpions out of their hiding places and into the streets and homes. Vicious rain, dust storms, and snow in the southern city of Aswan last week drove out scorpions as well as snakes. Pandemics, snowstorms in the desert. All right, we won't talk about that right now. But three people have died from scorpion stings and 450 people have been injured by the stings thus far. Those who have been injured are being treated with antivenom in hospitals as well as medical centers that are located in more remote areas, according to Al Haram health officials. They have even called in doctors who are on vacation to help treat the influx of patients. In the meantime, residents are being asked to stay inside their homes. Asraf Atiya, Aswan governor, also limited traffic for a time, closing local highways to prevent accidents due to limited mobility in the rain, the outlet reports. Scorpion stings can be lethal. The Egyptian fat-tailed scorpion. Don't fat-shame him. He has an eating disorder. Anyways, the Egyptian fat-tailed scorpion, a species found throughout northern Africa in particular, has been described as one of the most deadly in the world, according to the St. Louis Zoo.
Yeah, I'm like the guy in the movies that's always waving the sign around, the end is near. Now I'm kind of getting the last laugh. Who's the crazy one now? Man claims memory blank after pounding on door at 1 a.m. and running from police. by Eddie Ritz. Thanks, Eddie. This is from the Palm Beach Post. And a funny thing about this story is that it kind of ties in with Jimmy's show. They always get some weird news stories out of Florida. So, here we go. Here's a weird news story out of Florida to add to the collection. This is in Lantana, Florida. An unwelcome visitor outside a home in the 300 block of Pinewood Street at 1 a.m. An unknown man began knocking on the front door of the residence. Being that this is South Florida and home to plenty of strange people, as noted earlier, like those that might eat your face while high on bath salts, the resident's alarm level began ratcheting up. Telling the man through the glass to leave and that the police had been called, the man began repeatedly saying, "Let me in," while pacing around in front of the house. Realizing his attempts to gain entry were not likely to end in success, the man took off running and stopped by police a short distance away. He was detained and placed in handcuffs after finding a small amount of marijuana and one Xanax pill on his person. Police asked him what he was doing knocking on the door of someone he did not know at 1 a.m. And the man stated that he had been at the 24-hour store near the Cuban place, and then added that he may have been experiencing some paranoia when he approached the home. He then said he had been drinking earlier, and at that point claimed his memory of what he was even doing in the area was blank. He next added that he had been in some sort of accident, but did not know where it had occurred or what it even involved. He was arrested for loitering and prowling and for drug possession. A further search of his person revealed a small amount of heroin hidden inside a pack of gum.
They get that way underground. There can't be much to do. So now they have blue ones too. We don't care what they look like, we'll eat them. Any way they can fit on our plate. Every way we can conjure to heat them. We're delighted and think they're just great.
Alright, guys. Listeners, individuals, this is a potato story. And the more I looked into it, the more disgusted I am by it. But I'm a little crabby today. So let's talk about this potato story. Maybe you like it. A potato the size of a small dog is found in New Zealand. From Wellington, New Zealand, Colin and Donna Craig Brown were weeding their garden in New Zealand when Colin's hoe struck something huge beneath the soil's surface. As the couple knelt down and began digging around the object, Colin wondered if it was some kind of strange fungal growth, a giant puffball. After Colin pried it out with his garden fork, we all need one of those. "Hey, honey, can you get me the garden fork?" He scratched away a bit of the skin and tasted it. "That's a great idea, Colin. A strange fungal growth in your farm. Let's dig it up with your garden fork and taste it." Anyways, Colin tasted it and he decided it was a potato. His wife Donna says, "We couldn't believe it. It was just huge and not exactly pretty either. It has an ugly mutant look." But it's quite possibly the largest potato on record. When the couple lugged it into the garage and put it on their scale, it weighed a remarkable 17.4 pounds. That's equal to a couple of sacks of regular potatoes or one small dog. I like the way they compare it to a dog. Like, isn't anything the weight of a small dog at some point? Anyway, in the weeks since their unusual find on August 30th, the couple's potato has been something of a celebrity around their small farm near Hamilton. They've named this potato Doug after the way it was unearthed. Wow, that is original. Doug. Oof. And Colin even built a small cart to tow Doug around. We put a hat on him. We put him on Facebook, taking him for a walk, giving him some sunshine. It's all a bit of fun. It's amazing what entertains people. So anyways, these people contacted the Guinness Book of World Records trying to gain entry for the largest potato on record. They didn't immediately reply to the request for an update on their application. Colin says he doesn't have any secret gardening tips. Usually they just throw a bunch of cow manure and straw on the garden and wish for the best. He said they've been growing cucumbers in that area of their garden before the weeds took over and hadn't planted any potatoes. Doug must have been self-sown and quite possibly growing for a couple years or more. Yeah, what a miraculous birth there. It's a mystery to me, Colin said. It's one of nature's little pleasant surprises. But Doug hasn't proved an easy charge to look after. As the couple showed the potato off, it began drying out and losing weight. Mold started growing from its wounds. He was getting a little pungy, said Colin, referring to the potato smell. So Colin cleaned up Doug as best as he could and put the potato in the freezer where it remains. But Colin may not be done with Doug yet. An amateur brewer, Colin said he's keen to turn Doug into a nice drop of potato vodka. Who the freak would want vodka from your rotting, spongy potato, rotten, mutant-looking... I'm sorry, I escalated. There's your potato story.
Hey, I'm right there with you, brother. What were they thinking? Time Traveler warns of impending alien invasion. Will there be an alien invasion next year? A man claiming to be from the future has already amassed over 1 billion views on video sharing site TikTok. We've heard from a few self-professed time travelers over the years, a trend which gained prominence in the early 2000s when a man named John Teeter started to frequent online message boards claiming to be a soldier from the year 2036 who had gone back in time to warn humanity. While Teeter was later exposed as a hoax, there have been numerous copycats in the years since, usually with the alleged time traveler making similar claims about future calamities. One of the best known current examples of this user on TikTok by the name of Aesthetic Time Warper, who, as is typical, has been warning people about the future. One of his predictions in particular has been doing rounds online over the last few days because it concerns something that he claims is going to happen as soon as next year. Earth, he claims, will be invaded by hostile extraterrestrials known as the Nozick, who will disguise their arrival as a meteor shower for some reason.
There will be a very large meteor shower that lasts for 2 weeks. It will be seen in the northern hemisphere containing the Nozick message, he said. One of the meteors will seem different than all the others. That is because it is a ship landing on Earth, starting preparations for the first Nozick war.
It's when you look at some of the other predictions made by Aesthetic Time Warper, however, that you quickly realize how unlikely it is that anything he says will actually happen. According to one of his other predictions, for example, three teenagers will open a portal to another universe next month using an egg from a Tyrannosaurus Rex. He also claims Atlantis will be found next year, and it will be inhabited by human-like fish.
Hey, little girl, is your daddy home? Did he go and leave you all alone? I got a bad desire. Ooh, I'm on fire.
New York man bursts into flames after being tasered. A 29-year-old upstate New York man who covered himself in hand sanitizer burst into flames after police used a taser on him, according to a local report. Jason Jones had entered the village of Catskill Police Department last week and got into a confrontation with officers. Police told the paper that Jones, who was known to them from previous encounters, appeared intoxicated and officers used a taser to subdue him. "I think they were afraid he was going to hurt himself, and that's what started it," Chief Dave Darling said. "There are still details that we're trying to develop." It was unclear when Jones poured the hand sanitizer over himself and whether officers witnessed him do it. Jones is in an intensive care unit at Upstate University Hospital in Syracuse, according to the paper. People familiar with the matter told the paper that his condition is grave. The incident is under investigation by the Greene County District Attorney's Office. Something's a little fishy there, I think.
Tell me now, baby, is it good to you? And can you do the things that I do? I can take you home.
That dude was probably just some kind of big germaphobe or something. He was afraid the cops would get him sick or something.
Cash scattered across a Southern California freeway sent drivers into a frenzy. By Dustin Jones. Thanks, Dustin. Traffic came to a stop on California's Interstate 5 Friday morning after an armored car happened to spill cash all across the freeway just north of San Diego. Several drivers and passengers jumped out of their vehicles to grab what they could, but the police won it all back. The armored car was traveling north along I-5 in Carlsbad at about 9:15 a.m. when one of the doors unexpectedly swung open and bags of cash flew everywhere. Cars parked on the shoulder and in the middle of the road as motorists and passengers raced to collect the bills, mostly ones and twenties, littered across the ground, the San Diego Union Tribune reported. But the California Highway Patrol is warning those who seize the moment to turn the cash in. "I highly suggest to anybody that picked up that cash out there, it's not your cash, so you turn it in immediately to the CHP office in Vista," CHP Sergeant Curtis Martin told reporters. Two people were arrested at the scene for allegedly collecting what they could, and others turned in what they had collected, the Tribune reported.
If love gushes from my heart like water from a spout.
California man sues psychic who said she could remove witch's curse from X. He's asking $25,000 in damages. A California man is suing a Los Angeles psychic he paid for fraud because she allegedly claimed she could remove a witch's curse put on him by his ex-girlfriend for $5,100. Coincidentally, the psychic's credit card bill was $5,100. Nah, I just made that up. But anyways, last month, this Moro Restrepo found psychic Sophia Adams' website that billed her as a PhD life coach and psychic love coach, according to the City News Service in Los Angeles. This made plaintiff more confident that he was speaking with a professional that could help him, the lawsuit stated. Adams gave Restrepo a tarot reading when he visited her office in Palo Verde's estates and told him that he had a mala suerte, or bad luck, put there by his ex-girlfriend when she hired a curse-casting witch. Adams allegedly claimed his family would be unhappy and in danger unless he paid her $5,100 to remove the curse. Restrepo reportedly paid Adams a $1,000 deposit, but she did not in any way help the marriage, the lawsuit said. Restrepo says he has suffered anxiety and sleepless nights and is also suing for intentional and negligent infliction of emotional distress along with negligence and civil conspiracy. He is asking for $25,000 in damages. The lawsuit also names Adam's business psychic love specialist by Sophia, her husband, her daughter, and her landlords for her business, arguing that they all knew she was using her position to take advantage of clients, but did nothing to stop her. Adams did not immediately return Fox News' request for a comment.
$25,000. Wow, a lot of emotional stress there. This one once again proves that Florida is kind of weird. Mysterious metal box washes up on Florida beach by Ben Hooper. Thanks, Ben. A mysterious metal box that washed up on a Florida beach might be an old ballast tank from a ship, officials said. Visitors to Playa Linda Beach in Brevard County said they first noticed a large rusted item in the boardwalk number 7 area on Friday.
It looks like an oil drum of some sort, a big drum, said Tom O'Shea.
Kristen Neffel, resources manager of the Canaveral National Seashore, said officials aren't sure what the object is, but it might have once served as a ship's ballast tank, a compartment that holds water to stabilize the vessel.
That's our best guess at this point, Neffel said.
Neffel said officials determined the 20-foot-long box is empty, so it does not pose a health risk to the public. She said officials are still working on a plan to remove the object.
Unlike maybe some boats or other things that wash up, where we can kind of chainsaw it apart and get it over one of our boardwalks, it doesn't look like it can be cut up, Neffel said. So it's going to have to be removed from the water, from the ocean side.
There's always a good time to be had in Florida.
New York firefighters rescue naked man stuck in bathroom wall for several days. Firefighters in upstate New York on Friday rescued a naked man who was stuck for several days inside the bathroom wall of a theater, fire officials said. The Syracuse Fire Department responded just after 7:30 a.m. to the Landmark Theater after employees heard someone banging on the wall and yelling for help, the department said. The adult male, who was not immediately identified, was believed to have entered the theater 2 or 3 days ago, fire officials said. It was not immediately clear how he was able to get behind the wall, according to the department. Firefighters with Rescue Company 1 drilled a hole in the wall and used fiber optic cameras to find the man's exact location in the wall. After determining the best way to extract the man, officials said firefighters carefully cut through several layers of drywall and structural clay tile to reach him. The 39-year-old man was not wearing any clothes when firefighters freed him, Syracuse Fire Deputy Chief John Kane said. The man was taken to Upstate University Hospital for treatment. Kane said the man appeared uninjured and would likely be treated for dehydration. I have no words. Well, I think I found a perfect mate for that gentleman stuck inside the theater walls. A woman found naked in Florida storm drain is rescued again. A woman who was missing for 3 weeks and then rescued from a Florida storm drain found herself in another underground tunnel system in Texas over the weekend, according to media reports. Lindsay Kennedy, 43, climbed out of a 6-foot drain pipe Saturday night and was taken to a hospital, her mother told West Palm Beach, Florida News. She's been checked into a rehabilitation facility in Texas when she wandered off. She was last seen near Arlington, authorities said, and they told the news outlet that the Grand Prairie officer spotted her. When they approached her, she slipped into a nearby storm drain. Her family tracked her using an app on her cell phone that noticed her last location prior to going underground. As a precaution, her loved ones dropped bags of food and Gatorade in nearby manholes in an effort to sustain her. Kennedy was in the hospital on a psychiatric hold, and her family reported she has psychosis and post-traumatic stress disorder for years of being in an abusive relationship. In March, Kennedy was pulled out of a storm drain while naked in Florida's Delray Beach after having been missing for 3 weeks. She told authorities she became trapped while exploring a tunnel she found while swimming in a canal near her boyfriend's home. She got lost inside the tunnel system after several turns. After she was rescued, authorities said she was so weak she couldn't even stand on her own. I don't know how much longer she would have been okay down there, a spokesperson said. The idea that someone might be down there for any length of time is disturbing. It's dirty, dangerous. There's snakes, rats, garbage, dirt, and leaves. Anything that's on the street washes into the sewer, and it smells terrible. Let's hope these two people find each other. In Dark Places, your love connection.
So in related news, I think that naked man might have a tough decision to make, because last month there was a naked woman seen down at the flood wall in downtown Williamson, West Virginia. The woman appeared to be high on some kind of pills or something, and she was chanting some weird phrase. And a couple of onlookers decided to get their phone out and film her. And apparently, she was never arrested for the incident because her picture did not appear on any kind of recent arrest records or anything like that. So, there could be a clash of naked women soon.
Deer Runs Loose Through Michigan Church by Ben Hooper. Thanks, Ben. Pastor Amanda Ecker said she and her husband, Luke, who is also a pastor, arrived at the Grace Christian Fellowship in Sturgis and discovered a window had been broken. Ecker said she then heard a banging sound inside the building.
I yelled for my husband. They're still here. And my husband went running in, and sure enough, and there was a break-in, but it wasn't what we expected. It was a 10-point buck.
Ecker told WWMT-TV.
He couldn't believe it. None of us could believe it. If you watched the video, you heard me say, oh my word, that was my first reaction.
Ecker's video of the buck running loose inside the building was posted to the church's Facebook account. The footage shows the deer jumping at a wall and climbing the stairs to the balcony in its search for an escape. The couple said the deer eventually left through the same window it had broken. Said the damage to the inside of the church was minimal.
That's about all the news from the unknown we could find for this week. We appreciate you listening. We'll be back again next week. God bless you, and see ya.
My goodness gracious, is this Junebug from the In Dark Places news program? My children were up all night listening to your In Dark Places stories, They were terrified and scared. They were scampering up and down the stairs all willy-nilly, to and fro, all night long, shivering and shaking and crying. And I just want you to stop these terrible, scary stories. Stop it! You're ruining my life!